Unit 4 end of unit question, page number 66. So the first question, Takafumi investigated variation in bean pods. Variation, we studied a species, variation species, bean pods. He picked 20 bean pods, all from the same species of bean plants. He counted the number of beans in each pod. These are the results that he wrote down. So 7, 3, 8, 6, 3, 4, 7, 5, 5, 8, 6, 4, 6, 7, 5, 5, 6, 5, 4, 8. This is the 20 bean pods result. Then the first question, calculate the mean number of beans in a pod. Show how you worked out your answer. You know, we studied how can we find the mean or average. What you want to do? Add all the numbers. So 7 plus 3 plus 8 plus like that. Add all. Then divide by the total number. Total number already they are given there, 20. So if you are adding all the number, you will get 112. So 112 divided by 20. So we'll get the answer 5.6. That is the mean value, 5.6. 112 divided by 20 equal to 5.6. That is the mean value. Then question number B, copy this result table. Use Takafumi's result to complete it. So the first column, number of beans in a pod. Then the second column, we want to do the tally mark. The third column, number of pods. So you know we have done the value start we have from 3 to 8. So the first column we have written from 3 to 8, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then we have to count how many three there in this reading. We have to check how many three there. So you can see there is only 2, 3. So mark the tally here. First, we are going from left to right. When we are seeing three, mark here one tally. Then again go, again we are seeing three, mark again tally, like that do. So we will get here 2, 3. Here 1, 3 and here 1, 3. So mark the tally mark. Then second, how many 4? So see the reading, we can see 3, 4. Then how many 5? Check from the begin. How many? If you are seeing 5, mark tally. Again 5, mark tally. Again 5, mark tally. Like mark tally. So I got 5, 5, 5. Then 6, 6. How many 6 there? See the reading. You can see on the screen or you can see your textbook. So see the reading, how many 6 there? So start from left. When you are seeing 6, mark one tally, the column, 6 column here, mark one tally. Again, you are seeing 6, again mark tally, again, then again. So I got 4, 6. Then next 7, 7 column. So see how many 7 here. So the first one is 7, then go, where is the 7? Like that, you mark tally. So I got 3, 7. Then next 8. 8 there. How many 8 there? So here 1, 8. Then here 1, 8. Here 1, 8. So 3, 8. So like that, you have to go through the reading and you have to complete. First, write here number of beans in a pod. Start from 3 to 8. That is the reading. Look here, the values. So from 3 to 8, then each one you have to check how many 3 there, how many 4, how many 5, how many 6, how many 7, how many 8. Tally mark. Then that tally mark right here, total 2, 3, 5, 4, 3, last one 3, like that. So this is the method of making the result table. Then question number C. Copy these axes onto a large piece of graph paper then complete a frequency diagram to show its results. So here they have given the graph paper. Just we have to draw enough. So x-axis you have to take number of beans in a pod. Already they have written. And the y-axis number of pods. So we have the reading. By using that reading, we want to draw the graph. So x-axis number of beans in a pod. You can take it is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Like that, x-axis you can take. And y-axis also like that. 0, here 1, 2, here 3, 4, 5, 6, like that. You can take. Okay, listen first. After that, I'll give you a chance for clearing your doubt. Okay, listen. So like that, draw the x-axis and y-axis. Then mark. Starting 3. So 3, how many? 2. So the 3, we drawn a bar chart 2. Then 4, 3. So next 4, 3. Then 5, 5. Here 5. And y-axis also 5. Like this. 6, 4. Then 7, 3, 8, 3. Like that. We can draw the frequency diagram. So that is the method of drawing the. Then question number 4.2. The diagram shows a small animal that lives in water. Very, very small animals that lives in water. Here, they have given the magnified picture. It's a magnified picture. Then they mark something. It has an antenna. It has jointed legs. It has an exoskeleton. They have given some point. And in the question also, they have given it is an animal. Then they have given 3 marking. Then they are asking, they have given down 7 options. Which 3 of these groups of organism does these animals belong to? So out of the 7, which 3 it belongs to? That you want to find. First option, animal. So in the question itself, they are saying it is an animal. So we can easily circle that. It is an animal. Then secondly, the picture. Picture, it has an exoskeleton. So if you see exoskeleton, you can easily understand it is an arthropods, no doubt. So animals, arthropods. Then the third one, we want to do 3 circle. The third one we want to find. So next option is insects. So it is an exoskeleton, so it is not an insect. Then they are saying vertebrates. It does not have a backbone. So no vertebrate. Then crustacean. So look crustacean. Crustacean having jointed legs and in a exoskeleton. So the third point is crustacean. So it is an animal, it's an arthropods, and it is a crustaceans. Then next myriapods. Myriapods actually need number of legs. So it is not a myriapods. Then amphibians. Amphibians is a vertebrate. So not an amphibian. So the answer is it is an animal, it is an arthropods, and it is a crustacean. So that is the answer. Then next question, 4.3 question. A scientist studies birds in New Zealand. The photograph show 2 kinds of parakeets that live there. One is yellow crowned parakeet and second one red crowned parakeet. You can see the picture. One is yellow crown and second one is red crown parakeet. Both are parakeets, but difference. Then the question A, explain why scientists give Latin names to birds and other organisms. Actually, this question I have given as a homework for you. Why there is the need of a Latin name? So that question is coming here, the end of question. Why the scientists given an Latin name? Already you know the answer. What is the answer? So that each organism has a unique name that it does not share with any other organism. This Latin name only for this species. It's an unique name that it does not share with any other organism. The name is the same all over the world. All over the world, everybody using this name for that species. So that is the use of the Latin name. Then question B, explain meaning of each of these terms. Already we studied that species. Many times we discussed that, what is species, the definition. A species is a group of organisms that share the same characteristics and that can breed together. That is the definition of species. Second one, habitat. Habitat means, so habitat we study already before unit also, many unit we studied. Adaptation, that unit we studied habitat. Habitat is the place where an organism lives. So, you know, this type of definition, species, habitat, like that, understand, because it come for the mass, the following, choose the correct, like that. So, understand that. Then question C, the scientists concluded that the yellow-crowned parakeets and red-crowned parakeet did belong to different species. What evidence did she have for making this conclusion? Why they arranged them in different species, both of them? You know, they have a different Latin name. Why they arranged in different species? That is question C. Because they did not find red crown and yellow crown parakeet breeding together. They did not find yellow crown and red crown breeding together. That's why they arranged them in different species. Maybe they have some same characteristics, but they arrange different group, different species because of this. Then question D, suggest what the scientist should do to be even more certain that her conclusion is correct. Choose from. Here they have given three answers. Choose from the correct answer. What is the first point? Looking at stuffed specimen of parakeets in a museum. Next option, checking more pairs of parakeets in the wild. And third option, looking at other species of parakeets. From other species, they can conclude this. So the answer is the middle one. What is the answer? They have repeated the experiment, checking more pairs of parakeets in the wild. From the wild, they have checked more pairs of parakeet. Then finally, they arranged this conclusion. So the answer is the middle one. Then question number 4.4, very important question and very easy question. They have given three plants there, plan A, plan B, and plan C. The photograph shown parts of three plants, plan A, plan B, plan C. Then copy and complete the table. Down the picture, they have given a table. That table you want to complete. First column what? Plan A, B, C. Second column, major group of which it belongs. You know, we studied there are four groups of plants: mosses, ferns, conifer, and flowering plant. Out of this, which group belong this? That you want to find. You want to give a reason also. Don't write simply. So we want to write a reason. Okay, first one. See the first plan A. Which group it will come? You can see there is ferns. So we can include it is in a group of ferns. So the major group is fern. Reason it has ferns. And the plan B, you can see there is cones. So we can say it is a conifer. Reason it has cones. That's enough. Then C, already you know the answer. You can see there is a flowers. So we can say it is a flowering plant. So A, fern, because it has ferns. B, conifer, reason it has cones. C, flowering plant, reason it has flowers. So this is the question number 4 and the end of unit question, finish. Now take the workbook. Page number 34. Page number 34. Exercise. exercise 4.1. People sometimes breed a female horse with a male donkey. The offspring is called mule. Remember the name, the offspring is mule. Workbook, page number 34, take. Mules are big and strong like horses. They are fit and easy to handle like donkey. Mules are infertile, that we studied. Should be infertile. Then see the question. Write down three similarities between a horse and a donkey. Very easy question. You have to write three similarities between a horse and a donkey. You can write first similarity, what? The shape, the size. And second similarity, you can write both of the having four legs. And third similarity, you can write both of the having hairs. Like that, any 3 points you can write. Then question number two, write down two ways in which a donkey differs from a horse. How they are differ? So the first difference, you can say the donkey is smaller and the horse is bigger. You can write 1 point. And second difference, you can say horse having long hairs and long tail, but donkey having less hairs only and less the tail only. That you can write. And also both of the having what different Latin name. That's an important point. Both of the having different Latin name. Then question number three. Find two pieces of evidence in the information on page 34. There's a picture from that picture showing that horses and donkeys belong to different species. Even though they have some similarities, then why they have in different species? You want to give two evidence. First evidence, second evidence. First evidence, you can say why they are both of them in different species, because they have different Latin names. And secondly, they cannot breed together to produce a fertile offspring. If they are breeding, the offsprings are infertile. The offsprings are infertile. So they cannot breed together to produce a fertile offspring. That's why we arrange them in the different species. The two reasons. Both of them have different Latin names. Then question number two, page number 36. The students in Nisha's classroom come from many different countries. Nisha recorded the hair color of 10 of her friends. The hair color. So their name and their color she has given here. Some having red color, some hair having black color, some having brown color, some having blonde, like a gold color. So like that. And their name and their color she given here. Page number 36, you can see. Then the question, complete Nisha's result table. See the screen. And Nisha's result table we want to complete. So actually here there are four colors. Hair color, black, blonde, brown, and red. Okay, then our duty, go through the data, then make a tally mark. Check how many black there. So you have to count. You have to go there, each one, then mark a tally mark. The first person, red color. So make a tally in red column. Second, black. So make a tally mark in black column. Then again, black, mark the second black. Then blonde. So make a tally in the blonde column. Then again, black. So make a tally in the black column. Then again, blonde. Make a tally in the blonde column. Then brown. Make a tally in the brown column. Then again black, so make again tally, again black, and finally brown, so make brown. So like that, you have to do tally mark first. After that, count the total and write here. Here black is 5, blonde 2, brown 2, and red only 1%. Totally 10, 4, 7, 9 plus 1, 10%. So result tab is correct. That is the question number one. The number two, complete the frequency diagram to show Nisha's results. We said the frequency table is better than the tabulation. So we studied that. So we want to draw a frequency table. So see the screen. On the x-axis, we have to take the hair color, and y-axis, number of people. On x-axis, y-axis, you have to mark the values. You know that starting the small value is 1, the highest value 5. So we want to take the scale. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that. Y-axis, number of people. And the x-axis, the hair color. So draw one, first one. Yeah, you know, here's some. Okay, draw the black is 5. Okay, here write black, not brown. So black is 5. And a blonde 2. Then brown 2. Here brown. Okay. Then red 1. So we have to draw a frequency diagram. Okay. We studied that frequency diagram. So here black is 5. Draw 5. Black is 5. Then, okay, I will send you the pictures for you. Then question number 3, page number 38. Question number 3. Variation in holly leaves. PEMFO investigated variation in the number of prickles on holly leaves. The photograph shows the leaves. You know, here 18 photo of leaves given. So from that, you know, prickles means what? There's a small spines. You can see a small spines on the side of the leaves. That is called a prickles. So small spines. So see the first question. Count the number of prickles on each leaf and write them down. That is some risky work. You want to count how many prickles in each leaves. So that we want to do. Count how many prickles. You know, prickles means, I said you, the small spines, the side of the leaves. So this is a result I got. You can see here the screen. That's a result. Maybe some variation will come because you want to count deeply. As some of the prickles are very small. So allow, okay. So the result working from left to right. The first prickle, 70, then 15, 14, again 17, then 15, then 17, 17, like that. You can see the screen. That is the result. You know, I said you, maybe some variation will come because it is some risky process, counting the prickles. Okay, then you can do your own way. You have to count and do your own answer. You can take your own answer, no problem. Then, you know, our aim is, what is the question? Calculate the mean, the number of prickles on the leaf. Okay, how can we calculate? Add the total prickles. So then divide by the number of leaves. So you have to add your values all, then divide with the number of prickles, that is number of prickles 18. So I got 176 divided by 18. So 15.5, the answer. You have to do your own answer. You have to count and you have to do. Then number 3, do the tabulation. Okay, draw a result table and fill it in to show the result. Organize the results so that you can use them to draw a frequency diagram. So actually the number of prickles starting from 11 to 20. 11 to 20, maybe there is no 18 and 19, but we are arranging in an order. We have easily draw the frequency diagram. So 11 to 20 start, then we have to check each leaves. So only one leaf, only 11 prickle, and another one leaf 12 prickle, another one leaf 13 prickle, But three leaves having 14 prickle, four leaves having 15 prickle, only one leaf having 16 prickle, but six leaves having 17 prickle, and one leaf having 20 prickle, like that. So the tally mark and the tabulation. Then, so question three, we want to tabulate that. And question four, we want to draw the frequency diagram. Question four, we want to draw the frequency diagram. So number of prickles take the x-axis and number of leaves take the y-axis. Then draw 11, 1, 12, 1, 31, but 14, 3, 15, 4, 16, 1, 17, 6, 18 and 19, no, and 21. Like that, draw the frequency diagram. Draw the frequency diagram. Then question number five. What is the question number five? What is the range in PEMFOS result? Range. You can see from the graph, the range from 11 to 20, the small number to the big number. So smallest to biggest. So 11 to 20, that is the range. Then the median. Median number, we want to find the middle number. So the median number is the number halfway between 11 and 20. The half between 20, this is actually 15.5. Then seven, what is the mode in the results? We said mode is the most. So which is coming most? So you can say the mode is 17. Then state one other feature that shows variation in this holy leaves. Not only the number of prickles, state any other variation. So we can say the length is varied and the area is varied, shape is varied. Like that, we can, many variations are there. We count only the number of prickles. So that is the section 4.4. Then come to the 4.5. Very easy. The table shows some characteristics of six vertebrates animals, A to F. Some vertebrates A to F. So you want to say it include in which group? It belongs in which group? So okay, see the A, animal A. It have no fins. It does not live in water. But it has hair, lungs, and wings. And dozen legs in water, dozen legs in land. Only hair, lungs, and wings. So we can understand it's a mammal. Then question B, what it has? Feathers, lungs, and wings. Feathers is there, lungs, and wings. So it is bird. Then question the animal C, it has hair and lungs, only that. Hair and lungs, so it is included in mammal. Then D what? It has, it lives in water and it has scales, it has lungs and it lay eggs on land. So it is a reptile. Then E what? E sometimes live in water and there is no covering. Gills when young, lungs as adult, no doubt. And lay eggs in water. Gills young and lungs at adult, so no doubt it is an amphibian. Then F having scales, gills, and lay eggs in water, so no doubt it is a fish. So that is the exercise 4.5. Then come to 4.6. The drawings show some invertebrates from A to F. Your duty, you want to include them in different groups. In the case of an invertebrates, we studied mainly molluscs, annelids, and arthropods. And in the arthropods, which subgroup? Insects or spider or crustacean or myriapods. Okay. So the first one what? Including insects. You can see six legs, everything. Then B is a spider. The spider, eight legs and exoskeleton, everything. Then C, you are familiar, C is a mollusk. Then D what? Becoming spider, eight legs are there. Then E what? You can see many legs, number of many legs. So no doubt, myriapods. Then F, it's an insect. G what? It has an exoskeleton. So and a antenna. So it is a crustacean. Then H, you can see segmented body. So it is an annelids. So this is the answers of the workbook.